Finally, we can animate variable fonts in After Effects using a free script made by Adobe. Let me show you how. So this is one of the slides from Zipping Zoo session at Adobe Max. The link is down below if you want to watch it. It's a great session. It's called For Type Lovers, a guide to animating typography. Now, towards the end of his talk, he showed few variable font animation that he created manually, frame by frame, as well as ranted about the fact that After Effects can't easily do it. I was there in the crowd advocating for After Effects. I raised my hand and I said that from version 2024, there's a way to achieve it. And now I want to show you how to do it. And by the way, I already did a tutorial about this technique using a third-party plugin, which is still valid. And you can check it out. The link is down below. But now I want to demonstrate how to execute it using a free script courtesy of Adobe. And yes, the link is also in the description. All right, so let's see how this works. So the first thing that we need to do is install few variable fonts that we can work with. And the easiest way to find them is using Creative Cloud. So I'll click on Manage Fonts. And then I'm also going to click Browse More Fonts. And this is going to open my default browser. And it's going to take me to fonts.adobe.com. Over here, I can click on Variable Fonts and I can have a look. And if I find something that I like, I can just install it. By the way, there are a few languages that you can isolate. So if you're just looking for something in your own language, go ahead and filter using this pop-up menu. I already did it ahead of time and I installed few fonts. So now what we need to do is install the script. Now you can find the script over here. Again, the link is down below. So if you click on it, you're actually going to get the file. I'll open a Finder window here and I already downloaded the script. So here it is. I'll double click to expand it. And inside this folder, this is the guide that we need to install. So I'll switch back to After Effects and I'll go to File, Scripts, and I can either run this script once or I can install it so it will be part of this menu. As things stand now, we can't install it as a script UI panel. So let's select Install Script File. I'll navigate to the folder, select the script, click Select, and it will tell me that one or more script files were successfully copied to the relevant folder, and we'll need to restart After Effects for this to work. So I'll quit After Effects and I'll relaunch it again. And now I'll go to File, Scripts, and here it is, Inspect Variable Fonts with few other things. You can read it if you like. I'm just going to open it and move it away so I can show you how to use it. So I'll select the first text layer over here, One Animator Hour, and we can see that I'm using the Nickel Gothic variable. If I click over here, and this is something new from 2024 and higher, we can access all the different variable options of this font. Now, you don't want to work from here. This is just to identify the font that you're going to use because we want to animate it. So I'll escape out of this pop-up menu, return to the timeline, make sure that the text is selected. And the first thing that we need to do is to select the variable font that we are using. So again, in my case, this is it. And by the way, you can actually use this script to change it to a different font. And again, we are talking about variable fonts only. So depending on what you have installed in your system, your list may look different. So just for the sake of demonstration, I'll select this font, Kofo Peshka VF0 Black, and I'll click on Apply Variable Font. And as we can see, this is going to change our font over here. All right, I actually want the previous one, so I'll reselect Nickel Gothic variable regular, and again, I'll apply the variable font. And now, in order to animate it, I'll click on Apply Controls for Axes. And this is going to add expressions for the source text, as well as tied it to two sliders. Now, depending on the font qualities, you may see more sliders. So in this case, we are seeing 0 and 0 for both the width and the slant. So we can start with the slant. I'm going to drag until I see that the font is back to normal. So in my case, 50. And then I can play with the width slider. I'll click and drag to the right. And I'm going to take it all the way to 100. Now notice that I can go above 100, but it doesn't have any effect on this font. So 100 is the maximum value in this case. It will affect the animation, of course, so just be mindful when you're animating those sliders. Since I'm here, I'm also going to create a keyframe for this slider, and then I'll need to do the same thing for the other text. So I'll select it, I'll make sure that this is the correct font, and then I'll apply controls for axes. And as before, I'm going to change the slant slider to 50. And in this case, I'll start with a narrow weight. So I'll create a keyframe for this slider. Then I'll go to the middle of my composition, in my case, 2 seconds. And I'm going to highlight the second text, type in 100, return to the first one, and I'll set this one to 0. So now it's very narrow. Now I'll go to the end and I can actually copy and paste the keyframes that I already have. So I'll select both of these layers, press U to see the keyframes, select this one, copy and paste it to the end, select this one, copy and paste it to the end as well. And then I'll click on the word slider for both of these effects, press F9 to ease the animation, and then I'll go to the beginning and show you how this looks. I'm also going to close the script, that's it for now, and maximize the frame by pressing on the tilde key. So this is it. I hope this is useful for you as much as it is for Zipping and me. If you dig it, please click the like button as well as subscribe to the channel. There is much more coming towards you in the near future. But for now, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.